Hey all, this is Abhi. Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to be seeing November plan with me. Before we get started with the video, there is one thing that I want to tell.
The first step I do before planning my new month is reflecting on my previous month, my wins, my lessons, and my mistakes. So I can plan my new month in a much better way with all the lessons that I have learned. So without any further ado, let's get straight into the video. Let's get started. The first thing I do before I start planning is to just tune into Spotify and tune into any calming, relaxing music like rain sounds or cafe sounds and something like that. And drinking water helps me stay refreshed throughout the planning process and I just get on that vibe. Let's start the planning for the new fresh month, November. Before we even begin the planning process, let me just quickly show you certain things that you might need for planning. So I'm taking some highlighters, crayon highlighters. I prefer them. You can choose whatever highlighter you want. I'm taking some brush pens, markers if you want them, and my favorite pen. And I start by answering these questions so that I can reflect on my previous month. Describe October in one word. Your happy memory in October. What are you proud of in October? A mistake you made in October. A lesson you learned in October. How can I improve in the next month? After answering all these questions, you now know how your October was. With all that energy, let's start planning our November. So the first thing you should be doing in this step is to divide your pages into multiple boxes. Now these boxes are actually for planning your goals in different aspects or different areas of your life. And also have some space for writing your word of the month. So you can choose any one particular word and choose to focus on that word throughout the month. And in those boxes, you can plan your goals. It can be either personal, professional, career goals, self-care goals. If you have any side hustle, you can plan on them. Health goals, relationship goals, spiritual goals, anything. So I'm choosing all these six categories. You can choose, pick and choose whatever you feel like having. Now, once that process is done, take a fresh page and start writing your top three goals. Overall, what are the top three goals you have for November? And break those goals down. I mean, take each and every goal and write down all the small tasks you should be doing in order to complete that goal. So take one goal, break that goal down and write all the steps you should be taking in order to complete that goal. Once you complete and break the goals for all the three important goals that you have set for yourself in that month, then we can move on to the next process. And in this process, I like to answer certain questions, and they are, what makes me happy? One area I should work on in November. Where do I find the most joy in my day? And how can I include that joy in my routine on a daily basis? Now, once that is done, now it's time to draw the calendar, just a rough view of the calendar of November. I usually like to start my month with Monday. People usually prefer with Sundays, but just starting my month with Mondays helps me stay. That is just my way. You can do it any way you want to. And please ignore my bad drawing skills. I'm just not so good at it. Now you can use different color markers to mark, highlight, and properly remind yourself on the important days, meetings, works, reminders, etc. Also have a small little box to write down the quote of the month. That will just keep you pumped up and it will motivate you anytime you're having a low time. And also have a small box in case you want to write or note down any reminders. Now I use different color markers to highlight different meetings or different things that I plan to do on those days. So just do that, and I just place a dot using that color marker, and I write them on the separate part of the page so that I can actually write down what does that color imply. Once that is done, I'm moving on to the next process, and I read a lot of books. So planning on what all the books that I have to read is very important for me. So that is what I'm doing. If you are not a person who reads a lot of books, then I must insist, start reading books. You trust me, you will love the process. And I also do this for any series or movies that I plan to watch. After that, go for the brain dump area to dump all your thoughts, ideas, how you feel, whatever you have. You can just use that particular space for dumping your ideas. Now, this is what people call a bullet journal. A bullet journal is basically something you design it for yourself, customize it according to your needs and wants, so that none of the pages in the planner which you might not use will go for waste. This way, whatever you want, you will be targeting and working on only those areas, and you will not be wasting a lot of time on sections and areas where you don't want to work on. Now it's time for me to plan my YouTube content. So usually I try to publish videos every Wednesday and Friday or Saturday. So I'm just noting down on all those days and the content that I want to publish, and I'm also planning on my Instagram content. So first I plan it according to the content buckets, and according to the content buckets I write down all the days by looking at the content month calendar. And once this is done, my most of the planning stuff is done. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. I'm also planning to do a live New Year plan with me. If you would want me to make that video, if you would want me to come live and sit together, plan for the new year 2022, please mention in the comments down below so that I would love to make that for you guys. And you know the drill. If you like the video, please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel and tap that bell notification so that you will get notified whenever I upload my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Happy November. I will see you guys next week with yet another interesting video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.